catch up on the day's news inside your mailbox. Send us your request to edbrief@vanguardlanka.com and we will send you Sri Lanka's first video e-newsletter free of charge to your inbox. Debrief, the news that matters.
Sri Lanka's rulers can set an example to the people by starting to pay taxes, a former governor of the central bank said.
Exemption of the bloated public service from direct taxation is a luxury that the economy can ill afford. Even if they are fully compensated for the taxes, which will be budget neutral, there could be a considerable gain to revenue from the non-public sector income now coming under the tax net. More importantly, the message sent that all the president downwards have to pay some tax on their income will greatly discourage the impunity with which all sorts of taxes are avoided or evaded in Sri Lanka.
He was speaking at the Sri Lanka Economic Association annual sessions 2010 recently. The main opposition UNP urged the government to provide schools with better facilities to students who qualify the year 5 scholarship exam.
අද ශිෂ්‍යත්වයේ සමත් වුණා කියලා එවැනි පහසුකම් සහිත පාසලක් ඒ දක්ෂ දරුවන්ට ලබා ගන්නටවත් රජයෙන් කටයුතු කළා නැහැ. අපි දැක්ක පහුගිය වතාවෙත් ශිෂ්‍යත්වය සමත් වෙච්ච දරුවන්ට කොච්චර මහන්සියලා ඒ ප්‍රතිඵල ලබා ගත්තත් Taman බලාපොරොත්තු වෙච්ච ඒ උසස් පාසල් ලබා ගැනීමේ අවස්ථාව ලැබිලා නැහැ. දැන් ඒ වෙනුවට මොකද්ද රජය කරන්නේ? රජය නොඑක් සීනි බෝල කතන්දර කියන. ඒ වගේම විවිධ ඇස්බැඳුම් කරන්න සූදානම් වෙනවා. පහ වසර ශිෂ්‍යත්වයේ සමත් වෙන්නේ දරුවෙක් රැකියාවක් ගන්නට නෙවෙයි. උසස් පාසලක් ලබා ගන්න. පහසුකම් සහිත පාසලක් ලබා ගන්න. නමුත් රජය පහසුකම් සහිත පාසලක් වෙනුවට දැන් අලුතෙන්ම කරන වැඩේ තමයි පහ වසර ශිෂ්‍යත්වයේ සමත් වුන් හැම දිනාටම පළවෙනි වතාවට සහතිකයක් දෙන්න අපි ක්‍රියා කරනවා කියලා ඇස්බැඳුම් පෙන්වන්නට උත්සාහ කරනවා.
Depositors of failed Golden Key credit card company could get some cash when Bentota located Ceysands Hotel, which is connected to the firm, is sold. Media reports revealed that 20% of the sales proceeds would be channeled towards the Golden Key customers. The report also revealed that other real estate, a hospital and three floors of Selinko house may be put into an asset management company. Sri Lanka has been nominated under few regional categories for Asia region in the World Travel Awards but lost to countries like India, Singapore, China, Vietnam, Thailand and Indonesia, which swept the boards. The regional awards engulf 47 categories including resorts, hotels, business hotels, travel firms, honeymoon destinations, airlines, hotel brands and niche sectors. Sri Lanka was among the 8 nominees in the Asia's leading destination category. Sri Lanka Tourism Development Authority and Sri Lanka's Ayurveda Pavilions also picked up nominations in their respective categories. Within the island, Hilton Colombo was named the leading hotel and Ayurveda Pavilions the leading resort. Sri Lanka's emergence from the war has boosted confidence and enabled the island to be named as a top destination for 2010 by US-based New York Times and the second best by the National Geographic magazine. A study conducted by 2 member states in the Asia-Pacific Traded Agreement shows that Sri Lankan exporters are not fully utilizing the agreement's benefits. This was revealed at a seminar on trade agreements organized by the Ceylon Chamber of Commerce.
Recent studies carried out by both by China and Korea indicates that our utilization rate is not very high. So utilization rate is around 50%. So that means there's another 50% of exports which should benefit, and people are not aware of, and they do not take the certificates of origin from the department for such shipment.
Sri Lanka exports the highest amount of items under APFTA after the FTA with India and is the only trade agreement which Sri Lanka partakes with China and Republic of Korea.
Utilization rate is not very high. And why utilization is not very high? There could be two ways. One is you are not obtaining the certificate of origin from the department, the preferential certificate. Two, perhaps your importer is not presenting it and getting the duty concession. So there could be two ways of looking at it. But it's necessary to discuss this among those exporters to China and Korea, particularly the product which I mentioned earlier. And it becomes even more critical because the fourth round of tariff negotiation is presently underway. And it is an extremely ambitious exercise.
Sri Lanka exports rubber, coin, tea, apparel, floor tiles, porcelainware and jewellery under APFTA to China, Korea, India and Bangladesh. The Italian Embassy organized a series of events with the aim of promoting Italian culture in Sri Lanka. Annual Taprobana 4x4 Challenge, the biggest event in the local 4x4 calendar, kicked off at Broadwalk Water's Edge with the aim of making it part of the international circuit.
Malaysia is probably, they call it the Mecca of 4x4 sport. So their event is in December and we also have Sri Lankans represented there. So that's the main event there. Then in also Sanya, China, which is in Hainan Island, also they have an event. And I think Philippines and Vietnam is coming into the calendar. So we are trying to get into Sri Lanka, we're trying to get into that international calendar.
Organizers say Sri Lanka has the potential to be a destination for adventure sports like 4x4 off-road racing.
The potential is immense for this type of sport because I have taken part in India and in China and in Malaysia, and I mean our jungles are, I think, by far it's more challenging. And the thing is, you know, the infrastructure is there. We don't have to go out and build a track. We have it. We have the natural infrastructure to do it. So the potential is great. This is 4x4 is just not just motor racing. It's adventure sport. So that the there's a responsibility which goes along with the sport, where we go to jungle environment, which is sensitive to environment impact. So our scoring is based on safety and environment impact. So we are trying to put like your highway code on the streets, we are trying to put a code of ethics into the jungle trails as well. So that's what this is all about.
Each vehicle is tested on its timing in completing a demarcated track, during which points can also be reduced over safety errors and environmental negligence. The Met Department predicts showers at several places in the western, Sabaragamo and central provinces and in Gaul and Matra districts. Thundershowers will also develop over the rest of the island during the afternoon or evening. There may be temporary localized fairly strong winds during thundershowers. General public is requested to take precautions to minimize the damages caused by lightning.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.